now turn to Dr. Lainey Arnold, Australia's foremost disaster expert. Dr. Arnold, what do you believe the space crew are going to do to get themselves out of this jam?
Well, Anne, I believe the crew would be undoubtedly considering performing a spacewalk to repair the ruptured
vehicle. Whoa, back up there, Professor. That sounds awfully scientific. What exactly is a spacewalk?
Glad you asked. I made this model earlier today before coming on the show to give our viewers a better picture of what's going on aboard here. A spacewalk is where one of the crewmen will lead the space station through the air.
Oh God, he's going to die!
No, Anne, it's all right. He's got a space suit on to protect him from the deadly void.
That was a close one, Professor.
Yes. It was, Anne. But just to get back to the matter at hand, once leading the space station in his spacesuit, he'll proceed up along the central module, past the solar array to where the oxygen tanks are located, and begin to repair the ruptured cable.
Ooh, that sounds very tricky, Professor. Now, I believe it was Scotty, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm no scientist, who performed much the same thing in Incident at Rigel 7. The dilithium crystals were threatening an implosion of the ship's engines.
Yes, it will be something like that. Except in this instance, the tear must be sealed using a space-age, self-adhesive, transparent polymer.
They sticky tape the hole.
Yes, precisely.
So, what are the dangers that the crew face during the spacewalk?
Well, aside from collision with space junk.
Oh my God!
Or perhaps the sudden decompression of their spacesuits.
But you said they were safe!
They could slip and fall helplessly into space like this.
Well, in all likelihood,